Hey, welcome back to Makers Movement. I'm Norseman, and on this channel, we make all kinds of cool stuff. So if you're a maker or you're into that, consider subscribing. Today, we're going to grind these bevels, and we're going to glue up the handles. So if you think you might want an opportunity to win this baby, go ahead and subscribe and follow this build. Let's get into it. First thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to go to my platen, and I'm just going to see if you see how that dark that edge is. That's from the heat treat. I'm gonna go ahead and just brighten that up, and I'm gonna put it on my tool rest, and I'm gonna grind it like that so that all the hash marks, the lines, go this way. That way when I scribe my center line, it really stands out bolder because it's actually, the scribe line is going against the grain lines of the grind. So for starters, it's important to make sure that everything is square. Now I've already squared this up, but I just wanna show you that as long as everything's square, then I'll get the good line that I need on this edge. And I don't get too obsessive about what belt I'm using. It's generally just some old belt off the rack that's already been pretty much overused. You can see the lines in there, and you can see how when I scribe my center line, it's gonna stand out. I'm still gonna put some blue die chem on, but that helps just a little bit more. I'm also gonna do the top of the back, because when I do my center line, I also put a center line here. That way, if I decide to grind in a swedge, I've already got a center line on it. And at the bare minimum, I can always see up here with my center whether or not my tip is centered. So if I have to adjust it left or right one way or another, that'll be easy enough to pick out. And that's good enough for what we're doing. I know it's nice and square. Now, I know a lot of people just use magic marker or whatever to lay out their knife and find the center. That's fine. I've found that with repeated dippings and stuff, sometimes that marker comes off, or if I wipe it or anything like that. You don't generally get that if you're using a layout die. I'll link to some layout die below. There's a couple of different brands. I prefer Dykem, but you get whatever suits you. Like I said, I'll link to it on Amazon below, and then you can pick whatever product you like. They also make like a die chem marker for that's great for just doing the edges, but it's not as good when you got to do the flats. And I prefer to do the flats because I want to mark where I want all my grind lines to be, how high I want it to go, where I want it to terminate, where I want my plunge line to be. I like to mark all of that out. The best way to do that is with die chem. A good sharp drill bit, approximately the same thickness as the blade, is what you need to mark the center. Now, they make a lot of fancy contraptions, but I found that this is usually the best way to do it, especially if you're surface grinding your blades and the thicknesses are gonna vary a little bit. I'm gonna mark it like this. And then I'm gonna do the spine as well, and then flip it over and do the same. Now, if you do most of your grinds before heat treat, you'll get an even better mark than what I have here. This is enough for me to go on. But I like to give my knives full heat treat before I take them to the grinder. And figure out about where you want those grinds to terminate. And just follow them through. It won't follow this exact line up towards this end. There'll be a little bit of a different thing going on here. But this gives me a good place to measure all the rest of it and see if it's symmetric. Now this can vary, and some people just go straight across for their plunge. On the hog knife, I prefer somewhere in the neighborhood of about 70 degrees, and I have to ensure that the plunge line doesn't intersect with my maker's mark. So I'll give it a little bit of a ricasso. And what I'll do is I'll just do a little sample right here and see if that's enough ricasso. And that looks pretty good. So I'm going to go with that at 70 degrees. And that's my knife laid out. Now I'll put a file guide on here for grinding just to make sure it's symmetric, so I don't have to mark that on the other side, because the file guide will take care of that for me. I don't always use this when I grind a knife, but I do always use it when I grind a hog knife, because of the angle, and you have to approach the grinder at the same angle every time, or you're going to end up with a really messed up looking plunge line. So because this has that forward leaning 70 degree angle, I always use a file guide. All right, so now that I got the knife pretty much surface prepped to go to the next step and start the coating, I'm gonna work on the handle. And I decided to go with a stabilized hard maple with yellow liners. I think that'll pop. I think it'll really show the channel colors as well. I think it'll be a really nice effect, really nice look. And that's what we're gonna do. We'll be right back. I hope you enjoyed this phase of the build. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button and ring that notifications bell so that you get notified when I have a new upload. Then you can find out how you can win it.